Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Happy New Year. Yeah, otherwise I'll come and greet you one by one. My name is Brian, and we welcome you to St. Pius X Parish family. In order to preserve the dignity of the Eucharist that we were about to celebrate, please take a moment to silence all cell phones and other electronic devices. In the spirit of Christian fellowship, please turn to those near you. Maybe someone you do not know yet, or someone alone, and extend a warm welcome and a joy-filled Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Happy New Year again. Today we celebrate the Epiphany of the Lord. In the Gospel of St. Matthew's, we will hear the gifts of the Magi. Gold, frankincense, and myrrh have come to be understood as symbols of Christ's royalty, divinity, and eventual suffering and death. They are special, because in giving them, the Magi acknowledge who Jesus was to be, our Savior. We pray that we will acknowledge Jesus as Savior in all that we do and say. The celebrant for our liturgy today is Father Chux. The Mass is being offered for Daniel Donovan, Jr., George Hart, Donald Holzmacher, Michael Wender, Salvatore Troia, Helen Liu, Monsignor John Dresden, Larry Carlucci, Father Dennis Raymond, Alicia Green. May we rise, please.
Oh, Let us pray. May the splendor of your majesty, O Lord, we pray, shed its light upon our hearts, that we may pass through the shadows of this world and reach the brightness of our eternal home. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
The readings are on pages 5 and 6 of the bulletin if you wish to follow. A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Rise up in splendor, Jerusalem. Your light has come. The glory of the Lord shines upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick clouds cover the peoples. But upon you the Lord shines, and over you appears his glory. Nations shall walk by your light, and kings by your shining radiance. Raise your eyes and look about. They all gather and come to you. Your sons come from afar, and your daughters in the arms of their nurses. Then you shall be radiant at what you see. Your heart shall throb and overflow. For the riches of the sea shall be emptied out before you. The wealth of nations shall be brought to you. Caravans of camels shall fill you. Dromedaries from Midian and Ephah, all from Sheba, shall come bearing gold and frankincense and proclaiming the praises of the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
When he has no one to help him.
From the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, you have heard of the stewardship of God's grace that was given to me for your benefit, namely, that the mystery was made known to me by revelation. It was not made known to people in other generations, as it has now been revealed to his holy apostles and prophets by the Spirit, that the Gentiles are co-heirs, members of the same body, and co-partners in the promise in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea. In the days of King Herod, behold, Magi from the east arrived in Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw his star at his rising and have come to do him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was greatly troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Assembling all the chief priests and the scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. They said to him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it has been written through the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, since from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod called the Magi secretly and ascertained from them the time of the star's appearance. He sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the child. When you have found him, bring me word, that I too may go and do him homage." After the audience with the king, they set out. And behold, the star they had seen at his rising preceded them, until he came and stopped over the place where the child was. They were overjoyed at seeing the star, and on entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. They prostrated themselves and did him homage. Then they opened their treasures and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they departed for their country by another way. The Gospel of the Lord. Good evening, everybody, and Happy New Year to you. This is 2022, that's what they said, right? believe them too. 2022. Today's readings and the subjects of today's readings, I just want to look at it, what in the political sense and what in the spiritual aspect of it. First of all, where the wise men came to go and see the child Jesus is what today we consider present day Iran. Okay? And you all can understand, I want to go into details what the situation is when we talk of Iran, Iraq, and all these places, especially when it comes to our country and other parts of the world. Iran. And they came to Jerusalem looking for Jesus. When they talk of the Magi, they were talking of not only priests, astrologers, just people, distinguished people in that society at the time, came together to look for this newborn child. They brought gifts. We mentioned those gifts. And again, you look at the spiritual interpretation of those gifts, they represent aspects of Jesus' life as well. So that's the political aspect of, you know, what the readings point to us today. And it reminds us also to pray for peace in the world, because there's crisis, especially in that area, in those areas today. And those crises keep mounting and mounting and never seems to stop. And as those crises rise, it affects us here in the United States, whether we like it or not. If it doesn't touch you because you have relatives, it touches your pocket, because our taxes go to maintain peace across the globe, right? So we need to pray for peace, because that is what Christ represents, peace. He brought peace to the world, and we will not stop praying until we see that peace in not only here, but also across the globe. The second thing I want us to look at or think of today is the spiritual aspect of what we celebrate, the child Jesus. We all journey. These wise people came. They left their home. If you look at the geographical location of where they came from and where they were going, probably it's over 1,000 miles or maybe more than that. And they came. So there was a movement from one place to another. Movement from one place to another. The same thing with you. You came from your home to the church. As a movement. Don't mind the distance. They were looking for Jesus. You come every single moment you come into the community gathered here to celebrate, to worship. You come looking for Jesus. The same journey. The journey of faith. The journey of trust. The journey of bringing ourselves as special gifts to God, but also bringing other needs we bring to God Himself as a journey. But there's also a spiritual aspect of it. The journey of life. That from the day of our birth until now, until maybe when we see God face to face, we are constantly growing in our spiritual life. We are on a journey. So we never stop. Always on a journey, always moving. And we travel those distances because we know that God made Himself manifest to us. He showed us His love. That is the epitome of what we celebrate today, the Epiphany of our Lord Jesus Christ. That God loved us so much that He presented Himself to us. So, my dear family, we pray for peace, and we also pray that our journey as Christians towards God will always be fulfilling and enriching to us as we present gifts in different forms to our God, especially during this season. And we pray that God will give us the strength as we begin this new year to continue to journey in faith and trust and hope in our God. May we rise and profess.
We pray the Apostles' Creed, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty. We rejoice with the good news of the Savior's birth. We bring our prayers to God our Father, who has worked wonders for us.
And our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. May the light of Christ shine brilliantly throughout the church, so that she may unite her members in following the example of the wise men, and kneel and worship Jesus. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For God's blessings on the new year 2022, that God will fill the coming days with health of body, mind, and spirit, renew the gifts of the Spirit within us, and inspire us with new ways to share the good news with others. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who have worked hard and made sacrifices in our parish and community, for the poor and the needy over this Christmas holiday period. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May the light of Christ overcome the devastation and fear caused by the COVID-19 pandemic, so that people will care for each other with the respect which the wise men showed to the child Christ and his mother. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the children of this parish who returned to school this week. We pray that they may be safe in their travels, in their homes, at school, and at play. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all who begin the new year weighted down by COVID-19 sickness, poverty, addiction, loneliness, or grief, including Emma Nugget, Khan Chu, Aidan Abdullah, Karen Petrus, Dorothy Walsh, Lucy Adick, Mary Ellen Phelan, Josephine Cucinella, John Campbell, that God's healing power will come to rest on them and for those who have fallen asleep in the faith recently, especially Daniel Donovan Jr., George Hart, Donald Holzmacher, Michael Wender, Salvatore Troyer, Helen Liu, Monsignor John Drayson, Larry Carlucci, Father Dennis Whelan, Archbishop Desmond Tutu, Alicia Green, and Chinny Achebe, and for the intentions of each one here, and this mass being offered for Daniel Donovan Jr., George Hart, Donald Holzmacher, Michael Wender, Salvatore Troyer, Helen Liu, Monsignor John Drayson, Larry Carlucci, Father Dennis Whelan, Alice Green. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of love and Prince of Peace, hear our prayers and inspire us to be witnesses of the light to all the world. And we make this prayer to Christ our Lord.
Amen. Who made you sleep?
acceptable to God, dear mighty Father. Accept, we pray, O Lord, our offerings, in honor of the appearing of your only begotten Son, and the first fruits of the nations, that to you praise may be rendered, and eternal salvation be ours, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is really right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, for today you have revealed the mystery of our salvation in Christ as a light for the nations, and when he appeared in our mortal nature, you made us new by the glory of his immortal nature. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come
may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all the clergy, and your faithful people, remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, who blesses Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, who may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace through our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all anxieties, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ, for the kingdom. Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Amen.
Let us offer to each other the sign of peace.
seated. Once again, on behalf of Father Chux, John, Pastor Staff, Pastor Associate, I'd like to wish you all a happy and healthy New Year. Our second collection this weekend is for the support of the Vincent de Paul Society. Our second collection next weekend is for the maintenance and repairs of our parish facilities. Thank you for support and generosity. Faith formation classes resume this Sunday, January 2nd. The night's free throw competition, as noted in the bulletin, has been cancelled for this year due to this outbreak of a virus, so to be really careful. Lectors are asked to pick up their 2022 workbook in the sacristy. The volunteers of altar care work quietly behind the scenes to prepare the altar and altar linens for worship. Can you offer an hour or two a month? This is a great volunteer opportunity for a family. Please contact the parish office if you're interested in helping. A little boy returned from Sunday school with a new perspective on the Christmas story. He had learned all about the wise men from the East who brought gifts to the baby Jesus. He was so excited that he could hardly wait to tell his parents. As soon as they arrived home, he immediately began, "I learned all about the very first Christmas in Sunday school today. There wasn't a Santa Claus way back then. So these three skinny guys on camels had to deliver all the toys." He further continued, "And Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, with his nose so bright, also wasn't there yet. So they had to have this big spotlight in the sky to find their way around." That was a little dry joke. While they were talking about the story of the three wise men, a woman asked the parish priest this question: "Do you know why God gave the star to the wise men?" When he professed his ignorance, and she told him, "God knows men are too proud to ask directions." If there had been three wise women instead of three wise men, they would have asked for directions, arrived in time, helped deliver the baby, cleaned the stable, made a casserole, and given some practical gifts. Happy Epiphany. Please stand for a concluding prayer and blessing.
Renewed by sacred nourishment, we implore your mercy, O Lord, that the star of your justice may shine always bright in our minds, and that our true treasure may ever consist in our confession of you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth in peace. This Mass is ended.
Thanks be
to God. You all have a blessed evening.
Yeah. good job.
Is it 10:11?